Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Organisms and Environment part 2. In that we are studying topic Decomposition in Ecosystem. Whenever somebody dies, the dead body goes to soil, and inside soil there are microorganisms which basically decompose. And there are not one type of microorganism, there are numerous present. Today we'll be studying about them. Decomposition. Decomposers are organisms that break down complex organic matter which is present inside soil or water into inorganic or organic substances like carbon dioxide, nutrients and substances. Whenever somebody dies, the body or the dead body is basically burned. And when you burn the dead body, whatever goes back to the soil, there are decomposers present or small microorganisms present, a type of scavengers which basically take out the last nutrients present inside that dead body and convert the dead body nutrients back to soil. So you're born from the soil and you go back to soil. There are four steps on which decomposers work, and the steps are fragmentation, leaching, catabolism and humification. When I say fragmentation, fragments are nothing but pieces. Whenever somebody is burnt or you put something to soil, you'll put a big chunk or a big piece, obviously. So now how this decomposition process works? The big pieces are broken down into smaller pieces, and this process is called as fragmentation or breaking in different small pieces. The next step is leaching. Leaching is nothing but converting water-soluble products or products which are mixable in soil into products which can completely and fully get converted into soil-like particles. That is leaching. The third step is catabolism. Catabolism and anabolism, we have studied. Catabolism is nothing but converting those products which are fragmented into particles which can be used by soil, and from soil it can be used by us human beings, for animals or for crop growth. As we all know, crops for their growth need carbon dioxide, sulfur, nitrogen, phosphorus, and during the process of catabolism, it is taken care that all these products are formed from that dead body, and all this process ensures that. The last process is humification. Now humification, there are two steps involved: formation of humus and formation of nutrients plus organic substance. Humus is nothing but soil-like substance. Ashes, which are formed when the dead body is burned, are a form of humus which get mixed into the soil, which is brownish in color. Whereas once ashes completely mix into the soil, what you get is nutrients or organic compounds. And this organic compounds or nutrients could be carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, sulfur, various other calcium, magnesium, molybdenum, all those things which act as phytonutrients or micronutrients or macronutrients for the plant growth. So this is where decomposers help mankind or ecosystem in a better way by giving back to the ecosystem or the soil, which will help every other species, whether it is biotic or abiotic, in their growth. Decomposition in ecosystem, or the decomposers involved in ecosystem. Decomposers break down complex organic substance or compound organic substances into organic or inorganic molecules, basically into simpler substances like carbon dioxide, nutrients like carbon, nitrogen, sulfur, etc. The steps in decomposition are basically four: fragmentation, leaching, catabolism and humification. The four steps of decomposition are fragmentation, that is breaking down of larger molecules or complex molecules into simpler molecules. Fragmentation is nothing but breaking down in pieces. The next step is leaching, mixing of water-soluble products into soil. Catabolism. Catabolism is nothing but a process that is carried out by bacteria present inside soil into simpler compounds or nutrients, you can say. And the last step, humification. This is nothing but formation of nutrients plus humus. Humus is soil-like particle. The basic picture of decomposition is that a detritus or a dead organism or a dead body is present which undergoes decomposition in soil after a certain period of time. After the four steps of decomposition, the last step is basically humification, the formation of humus or soil-like substances, and mineralization, that is formation of nutrients and organic matter, the formation of phosphorus, nitrogen, sulfur, all these things which are given to the soil for the growth of plants. Students, in this part of the chapter, we have studied about decomposition, the various steps of decomposition, and how humus or nutrients are formed inside soil, which makes soils more viable, more rich in compounds. I hope the topic of decomposition in ecosystem is clear to all of you. Thank you.